going to be speaking on their behalf this evening.
Okay.
All right, it's now 6:30, and I'm going to call to order the Select Board meeting of August 21st, 2017. We have several sets of minutes. I don't know if we'll be able to manage all of them, but we'll try. The minutes of August 7th, there was a public hearing that Jody and I presided over, and then a regular meeting that Jody and I attended. So I was fine with this. Okay, so by consensus, Jody and I say those minutes are good. I didn't see the minutes from Corey. Did he, I rewinded them.
I read them, yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna ask for your patience then and read them next week.
Are you able to edit them?
Yes, you should be able to make recommended edits.
There was just a couple of mine.
Yeah, so if you look at the top when you're in Google Docs.
I read them from my phone, so. But did he send them to us via Google Docs? It was just an attachment of the email that I read.
Well, if you look at them on a regular machine. Oh, he sent them as an attachment.
Yeah, so that's why I wanted to make sure.
Yeah, I don't.
However, we enter them in. It wasn't a major, just some minor tweaks, but.
Yeah, then they're not.
The world's not gonna stop if we don't.
Okay. Well, I haven't seen it, so I'll have to.
Fair enough.
All right, community input. Is there anything that you would like to talk to us about?
Sure.
Please come on up. And we'll, Sally will need your name and your address. Alan.
Alan Boer.
Dan Anthony.
And Alan, please spell your name.
Good evening.
Good evening. We have a very simple thing, at least we think it is.
Okay.
We wanted to dispute the tax assessment that we did recently.
Yep.
And I told us that we had to come here to do that.
Oh.
Not Kate.
Andrea.
So it's not necessarily the assessment, it's what we're being charged for.
Like the features and everything.
Yeah, the land. The amount of land that we're being taxed on.
Basically the land, right? The assessment says 1.8 acres. It's always said that, but it's a 100 by 700 lot. Do the math, 1.6. So we really just want to straighten that out. That's all.
Okay, so why don't, if you can, is, we'll take, I'll take notes. So that's just an error, so that should be simple. I suspect that, you know.
It doesn't seem like it. They've been talking about it for quite a while.
Oh, have you brought
so.
It to their attention then before? No.
Oh, you have? No.
Yeah. It just, now the land values have.
Well, that and, you know, don't pay that much attention to it, and I don't think it's that big of a thing.
Yeah, but still, it's good to get it correct.
Yeah,
I agree.
Exactly.
So Alan and, I'm sorry.
Tamia.
T-A-M-I-A. And it was the address again?
87 Rollins Road.
And you, it's the tax class
well,
is 1.8.
The deed, if you. Well, here's the assessment.
Okay.
Oh, I guess I'm sorry. It doesn't have it on there.
They were meeting with folks last week to.
Right.
We were away on vacation.
I was going to call. I didn't have access to a cell phone.
This
or
is fine. We'll relate the information and ask them ask the.
That's what
it does say 1.8 if you look at the town records. It always has 1.8 acres. Right.
And you say it is 1.
Right, it's a 100 by 700 lot. I have the deed. Everyone look at it. It's 100 by 700.
Okay. Which turns out to be 1.6.
Six.
Okay.
1.6 something.
It says 100 by 700. And you have the deed. Okay. Is that a copy of it, though?
Well yeah. I mean, the deed is registered. This is our copy.
Yeah, I don't want to take your copy.
And
I'm not going to
take
all of
it. I can put one of them.
I'll give you a simple.
Corrections are not as difficult as other kinds of issues.
I had to use an online conversion. Cool. So I'm hoping that that's accurate, but I'm sure it is.
Well, I wrote the 100 by 700,
yeah.
So, yeah.
Okay.
I'm sure that you'll be able to figure that out.
Hi, Suzanne. How are you?
I'm well, thanks. How are you?
Hi, thanks.
Nice to see you both.
Hi, son.
Looking good.
Huh?
You're looking good.
Thanks. How are you?
This is the original. This is the quick plan.
I believe in. You related to the Porters that owned land elsewhere?
No.
I could ask that a lot.
Well, I don't know them either, but I know that they're a name that's mentioned in the town.
They asked me, you related to Joe Porter? I said, no, but I'd like to have his money. I don't.
How are you, Nancy? Good.
I think.
Isn't that his family that owns the lot? Or am I making that up, the one that's for sale on the?
I think one of you, right, or at least they used to own that land, and that was all.
Maybe they used to or something.
That was all his, I don't know the answer to that. I always wonder if it's that and what's across the street, because that, I think the sign says it's like 3 or 4 acres of land, isn't it?
It's all on one side, though, it's all on the side with the sign, the 4 acres.
So would it, that has to be all those houses and everything.
No, it's just a field.
It's just that field?
It's a field. Whatever, yeah, it doesn't.
Doesn't look like that.
Well, you figure it's from.
It looks smaller than.
Smaller than.
The lane.
And I know nothing about, you know.
Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe they had to let you go.
You know. If you go a mile down the road, it was six, I'm sorry, if you didn't know. I'm not good with that stuff. It's a page, if you know, with an.
Yeah, that's me. And that's, sometimes it's hard to estimate. I think so, yes.
It's on the agenda, my engineer.
Yes. Good start.
That's really all we have.
Do you mind if we just continue then?
Yeah.
Okay, when Mike, well, we have to wait for Michael anyway, but you can give us. Yeah.
I want all of them.
Yeah, I know.
You'll be eating in front of me soon.
How many days?
How many days?
Yeah.
I know.
Happy about that.
So we just.
Kelly Anderson was married to Joe Porter's grandson.
Right.
Yeah, so, and they live around, yeah.
Part of the Porter family. I knew that.
Is she? Can I sit here? I can sit here.
All right, so we'll forward that along.
Okay.
Do you have an email? I can probably copy you on that, so Wayne. wayne.porter. @comcast.net. Okay, great.
Thank you very much.
And you see you there, and I see you.
You too.
All right, Department of Business, so Lieutenant, is that you over there?
It is.
They're all coming.
Slammers.
They should be on the agenda.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No.
Are you here for the Woodlands?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought, I'm sorry, I just made that assumption.
We're just part of the.
Okay.
Can you go sit?
No.
No, I'm fine.
Sit here, yes.
Two quick things. Good news, we've been approved, $4,000, and it's full for the grant for the emergency operation plan update. So we received an email today, we got a copy, so you folks can get that.
Great.
So, that's another grant done. And we'll be working on that in the near future, it looks like, for the next couple of months.
All right.
Then the second thing is just one purchase order, and this is for the 50-50 match for the new computers that you signed the grant for a couple of weeks ago. So now it's time to sign the purchase order, get the equipment. This will include the new e-ticket systems, everything. So we're gonna have it all installed at once and cross our fingers that all works after.
Like a charm, right?
So half comes out of equipment, and the other half will be the home security grant reimbursement.
Okay, well, Michael, would you like to do the honors, please?
Purchase order number 1262 to Glacier Computers for two MOT units and installation for a grand total of $7,343.14. Half of it coming from equipment fund, other from Homeland Security grant.
Okay. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 And they're going to be the rugged tablets, so hopefully they don't get broken. But they have that rugged
casing or something
around
it.
That's supposed to protect them.
Processed.
And that's all I have.
All right. So we saw our new officer Di Pasquale?
Sean, yes.
Sean, he came in tonight with Officer Hancock, because we sprang the alarm. So we're wondering if the keypad needs to be replaced. Or if you think it's.
I came up the other day and used it, it was okay.
Well, this happens on occasion, not every time.
We could have them come down and troubleshoot it, I guess.
Who would be the them?
That would be the alarm company out of Manchester.
No, that's probably an expensive trip just to come.
Well, we could put in a call, maybe they can see it internally.
Yeah, I mean, it happens, it happens to you a couple of times.
And when you press them, they don't, like, when it's working, it'll make the noise. And, you know, as soon as you start pressing them, it's not.
Right.
So, and it's a 50-50 shot at this point.
So.
It happened to me about, you know, 4 weeks ago, 5 weeks ago, and it just, the alarm goes off, it just.
Well, we could certainly make a call if you'd like.
Yeah, but let's not incur, let's just make a call and maybe get some advisor guidance or something, and then we'll talk.
Sounds like a plan.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Anything else?
Good weekend series.
Yes, great weekend series. Do it again this weekend.
Sounds good.
Bye, bye.
Thank you so much. Oh, yes. Actually, you're sweating, wondering why.
I thought it was just me.
Yeah.
How are you?
Good.
Hello.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Yeah.
How are you doing here?
Are you here for Woodlands, the Woodlands presentation, or are you here on other business?
Woodlands.
Woodlands.
Woodlands, okay, thank you. All right, so we will run down the agenda. There are no other department heads, but we do have some things in the department head sections to talk about. So Caroline's working with Tom to try to find a September meeting where he can come and talk to us about what he feels is needed to do septic plan review and. Anything about minimum housing standards, Michael?
Other than what we discussed last week.
Okay. Highway, our highway, the transfer station, the damage issue.
Do we want to try to state though that in the future, in the next month or so for our hearing, at least? If we get on the books, we may be more apt to.
We could do that. I would like to have something there. We can just sort of, us, you mean just us, get it on our calendars.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Sorry.
I would prefer not to bring it.
Well, we can table it, tell later if you want to.
No, just pick one. There's no reason why I couldn't be here at 6:00 on any one of our Mondays. As long as it's a Monday. As long as it's a Monday. And not the 11th. September.
Well, that's too soon. That's too short. Or even the 2nd of October.
All right, let's do the 2nd of October. Do you want to do that?
For the hearing?
Yeah, public hearing on housing standards. Well, let's do, I'm sorry, let us do 9:25. That's over. That's about a month, right?
Yeah.
All right. Does that work?
It's for me.
Over October.
And public hearing, minimum housing,
It's a public hearing?
Yes.
If we finish the minimum housing standards, yes, we will publicize a public hearing for September 25th to get input from the public on the minimum housing standards. Okay. All right, so back to highway transfer station.
I must think I was entering.
Anything further to do with that meeting? Or is it coming up now?
It's coming up on one, I have a sit down with Jay and his wife.
Michael, this is the first time in a while the three of us have been together, so I'd say.
I met with Jay and his wife before our vacation. They're looking to move it to somebody else anywhere. His wife has been doing the dispatch, he's been housing, the truck houses at his house. So they're looking for a town to house it and to store it appropriately. We do owe Valerie, talked with Valerie, I know Valerie, I co-copied you guys, that after this payment, then were less than even. They were so happy to get past the, I thought it was gonna be the end of the things.
So is, and is that payment happening this year or next year?
The end of this year, they wanna be, and then they'll still owe another $24,000.
But the truck would be worth more than that, so.
Right, right now they're upside down on the truck because of, they didn't charge enough to be able to get here. So we're meeting, we're all meeting again this Friday at 2:00 in Durham as a Land Re Commission.
Oh, the whole Land Re, not just the, not the, just the truck consortium?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So, to see where do we move from here, because Jay's retiring.
It changes.
Right. So they need someplace for the truck, they need somebody for dispatch, they need somebody to go to that over, and then we have to talk about the company itself.
All right, well, good luck with that.
Right. Time to go. Tough truck in business, it would seem like a good time to get out of it.
Yeah, to liquidate if next year. It sounds like a reasonable possibility.
Yes, she did.
Okay, thank you, Ben. Salt proposals. So we have salt proposals in there. We don't have to do them right now. They'll come up as we. Now, transition. Transition issues. Okay, so transitional. Transition issues have to do with the search committee. So far we have Michael Foyt, Jason Lavoie, Nate Mears.
Yeah.
And a board member, and we would like you to serve and you've offered to serve. So, would you like to try to assemble the first meeting? I think we should give the group a charge. And so I thought maybe we could work on that charge. So it seems to me they could be reviewing the job description. We had a request to review whether we wanted to sub out some or all of the snow plowing, maybe a route, maybe remove one truck, I don't know. So examine the snow plowing. The remuneration, you know, the compensation. Is it sufficient? Is it not sufficient? Should we consider hourly? Should we limit salary? So that sort of thing. I think that's, is there anything else that we should, we want the search committee to look at. All right, so I'll take a stab at editing drafting a job description. We'll leave it next Monday if that works. Michael Foyt is not going to be around. He's on the committee, so he's like on this week or next week, so I think we have a little bit of time.
All right, I don't have
email
or.
I'll send you, I will. Give you, I'll do
it. I'm assuming that we end it because it
yes.
Works. So.
Yes. Okay, thank you, Jerry.
Thanks. We will probably be until.
Okay.
Yeah, what was next?
What?
Is that the paper?
Yeah. Well, that's part of the meeting that Jody's.
That's what I'm asking. Part of the truck.
Trent with the Land Re Regional Cooperative. Doing this Friday. And also, I mean, it would be nice to have somebody who can oversee the current staff that are working at the highway station or are available to work at the highway station. And so we have Wayne is here Monday through Wednesday, roughly in a 7-3 window. I don't know that he always works that many hours, but that's the window. Then Mike is here Wednesday through Friday, again in a 7-3 kind of thing. So how would we best try to determine that, you know, they either are busy with things that we need them to do, or if they're not, that they don't, you know, we don't want to pay them to twiddle thumbs.
I thought I saw an email that there was given a list of things to do. That true?
I don't know.
Okay.
I remember reading it.
Okay. Where does that come from? Is it Caroline?
Yeah. I want to say Caroline's, but I'm.
Do you have time to
follow up with Caroline on the best way to.
Who has the phone number?
Jeff. Because he is available for emergencies, according to Caroline.
So how do we get in touch with Mike?
I would say check with Caroline. Because I've been doing it that way.
If it came from Caroline, it came from Jeff, right? It was a list you were playing. Things I can take care of.
He has written down, well, I'm gonna skip to number four for just a minute. And he did scratch out the roadside Boeing routes. But we need to arrange to have one of our folks, if possible, follow as a, in a chase truck to, you know, just with the light on as a part of the traffic control, and also to help with the debris to the extent that there's debris that's created in the road. So that's one thing that we need to have arranged for the end of September. He also has scratched out the road, road plowing routes, and you know what truck does what. So that's.
And where is this?
It should be with Caroline.
Okay. Because I don't have keys to get into the highway shed. So.
I would say check with Caroline and just make a set. There should be an extra set around for one of us. Yeah, maybe the
genius.
Mark just said the chief may have.
She's giving up a chair.
Okay, and we're, I mean, we're here to help. I mean, we don't, I feel like I just, what?
No, we don't dump on you.
Dump this on you, but it's, you have a certain affinity and
yeah.
It's nice to take advantage of.
I said, Janet,
so,
yeah. We got enough on you here.
All right.
Sit down on this for 2 weeks, I hope.
Are we going to table the determination process for now? So after the presentation?
Well, we still have
10 minutes.
Yes. Okay. We're scheduled to start about 7.
Okay.
All right, so the termination processes. So, I asked Caroline to spend some time thinking about this. What I came up with is we need keys, we need any uniforms or anything else that he might have that he needs to give back to us. She did calculate termination pay, and that's in the thing folder, so we can look at that a little bit later. I don't know if there's anything else that we want to add to this list that you can think of. Cell phone, very good. Excellent, yes. And then what we can do is also make a, you know, turn this into a checklist, and so that the next time we'll have something to use. Wouldn't that be normal?
Yeah. Can you have council just work over the ones that come in first? Whoever we hire next, they don't have to fit two cages.
Right.
So he just has to make sure that they're in the dirty laundry.
Yeah.
And clean laundry and all that gets sent to the person and tell them,
yeah,
we don't need these anymore,
we
now need
this.
These.
Super. Okay. Super. Anything else? I mean, if you think of something, just zip me an email so we can have it to the list. Okay. Anything else about highway or transition or anything like that?
We probably want to call the people that we do business with. And tell them who's not involved in the shop.
These chairs at the end of the hallway.
Oh, okay.
No, we're going to recess for a few minutes and get some extra chairs. Now, by the time we get the extra chairs, I can get started.
There's some in the stairs.
we're all leaving you.
Alright.
We're just walking out.
We'll let you know what we decide.
Right.
We're pretty much there. We're going to wait for the board to reassemble itself, and then I'll make an introduction and set some ground rules.
So I made
the
backup copy. So that's got all the data for the other two. Just brings the graphs. She's got the in that package the supporting data that drives those graphs. You know, the actual numbers, the line items in the spreadsheet.
Just waiting for Mike.
Okay.
I will remember that.
Yes.
Stuff.
Yeah.
He said he would.
We should wait for him.
That means he's gonna be late.
So board, I sent you, I forwarded along to us the request from Herbie Weta, who represents the Woodlands Association, to make a presentation to the board regarding some reval issues. So Herb is here to do that. I just want to remind all of us that this is the select board meeting. Herb is providing us this presentation. It's not a public hearing, so you're... Of course, the public is always welcome to attend and listen, and that's what we'll be doing tonight. The board will be listening to her and asking her questions.
Okay.
Is that did you want this, were you expecting something different?
Well, I was gonna speak on behalf of the neighborhood as the association president, but then I was gonna allow these individuals to speak on their own behalf, so.
Well.
But we don't need that, you know.
I mean, maybe I didn't quite understand that that was what you were hoping, I may have misunderstood that.
Mm-hmm.
We can see what the time is like, we can see what the board, how the board wants to proceed.
My piece will take about 12 minutes.
All right.
In fact, it might not even take that long.
All right, so let's go with you.
Okay.
And then we'll see how the board wants to proceed, is that fair?
Yeah.
All right.
Fair enough.
And we're going to, this is the best that we can do projection wise, unless we turn the lights up.
My question is if it could be made darker.
It's completely binary, it's off or it's on, so that's the only way we can manage it, so.
That's good, that's good.
All right.
It works.
Do you want it to be?
You're okay.
Thank you.
So,
Yet.
I'll protect them.
It doesn't look like it's working.
All right.
So thank you for allowing us to do this. Really, all we're looking for from this meeting is to help you understand the data. And the only thing we'd ask after this meeting is that you look at the actual data that I've included in the package, you know, the line by line. And there isn't a lot of it. Within a half an hour, you can read and digest this.
Mm-hmm.
And the second thing that we're hoping is that you'd be willing to, if you haven't recently, either let me accompany you on a little windshield tour of our neighborhood, including our waterfront access. If you got an extra couple minutes, you can help. Welcome to come into my $500,000 house and see what $500,000 is. So, I mean, I don't know if you've been through the neighborhood lately, but I'd love to just drive you through and help you get a sense of what's there.
I did drive through actually pretty recently because I think we said that the last time you were here. Or maybe when Nancy was here, we were looking for the possibility of paving the beginning of the road to just beyond River Road, I think.
Right.
And so I took a ride through. I was not looking houses, I was looking roads, to be honest. But I mean, there is a range. What I remember is there are a range of homes in the association.
Correct.
In the development. They're not all of similar size or ilk.
And that's one of the things that, you know, we hope you glean from such a tour. Along with looking at the riverfront access and the water views. And there's four homes that have, in fact, true water views. A couple of them are pretty impressive. I think there's seven total that have waterfront. Three of them can't. They have to cut down acres of trees to see the water. But so those are the only two things I ask, is that you read this data, you try to understand it objectively, not asking you to engage Avatar in any way. We've had our chance to do that this week. It's a little frustrating. But so the points are real simple, and they're summarized here. When you pull the data, it shows that. And first of all, I didn't cherry pick this data. I went, the little intro paragraph describes how I pulled it. The only data I got from Zillow was there was a few sales that were missing from Avatar's database. But wherever I say whole town, I just pulled them at random. I went street by street and picked the middle, you know, house on that street. Robert's Farm, I took every single house. And in terms of sales, I just went chronologically backwards through all the 2017 sales in Rollinsford. So I didn't attempt to pick high-end sales, low-end sales, or anything. That, you know. So the bottom line is this, the average proposed increase is 50% compared to 20% across town, 18% for Roberts Farm, 18% for properties over 400. I tried to think of different ways that Avatar is, you know, where their logic is. In terms of how they compare us. And granted, Robin's Farm is a lower, you know, value neighborhood than ours. We're not arguing that at all. The second point is, you know, here's the real rub. It's not the assessment, it's the rate of increase of our homes compared to every other home in the town. That makes absolutely no sense. And we're gonna go back 20 years, and I know folks don't really like history, usually the same folks that don't like science or math or facts, but history really matters in this case, because 20 years ago, we got data we're going to show you that makes a very strong case that any adjusting they were going to do for the newness of that neighborhood, they did in spades in 1997. And we've been paying for that ever since. So it does matter in this case. And Mr. Roberge was kind of like, surprised that I would even bring that up. But you'll see here why that matters. So whether you measure it by sales or just pure assessments, the average proposed assessed value increased 109% in this same period. The average proposed assessed value is $94,000 above the sales price. So 20 years ago, they argued that it's all about sales to assessment ratio, or assessment to sales ratio, if it's the same, flipped over. And that pure assessment is more of an art than a science, but when you get sales, then facts are facts. So this time we have enough sales to kind of undermine that position. And the fact that the sales to assessment ratio, or assessment to sales ratio for us is 118, and for the rest of the town is 0.97. And then I pulled the homes above 300 to say, well, maybe the thought is high-end homes appreciate faster. The rate of increase is greater. The rich get richer. But in fact, for those homes, it was 0.98. So there's a 20% disparity between assessment sales in just our neighborhood. I could find no other slice, no other neighborhood, no other category where anything was even. Every single slice I took was 0.98. Mm-hmm. And the increased assessments were either 18% to 20%. So go down to the bottom, final point. So at that time, the actual disparity between assessment and sales was not as great. It was about 16-17%. We argued, lost, abated, lost, went to the state and appealed, lost. But in fact, in retrospect, if you read the argument, and I've got it all right here, we lost the day that Avatar put the first number on the piece of paper. And that's what's the most frustrating then, and that's what's the most frustrating now. The appeals process, if you read the statement from the state itself, it says we have a burden to show the assessments are disproportionately high or awful. And in fact, anyone with any kind of acumen in cranking numbers would say we absolutely show that. But the appeal is dead on arrival. So the frustrating part is we feel we've been paying this delta for 20 years. And then for them to come in now and to once again make another profound adjustment, just it defies logic. Flip to the graphs. Pictures are, worth a thousand words, and I'll pretty much shut up. So that is a historical.
Do you want that one or do
you? Yeah, no. Let's show that one first.
Okay.
And not all my neighbors have actually seen this one just yet. I'll pass the copy around. But that ramp there, between 96 and 97, was that one time adjustment. Granted, the
that
neighborhood.
Steep slope.
Yeah, the neighborhood was new. We had some empty lots. We had some new. That period is when some of the bigger, really grand houses went in, granges. So that Avatar had a point. It was a growing neighborhood. They couldn't project what it was going to be. So the sales to assessment was of value, but they went a lot with their gut feel as to where this neighborhood was headed. But a 16% disparity, we got absolutely zero. Recompense. They basically ignored everything and said, this is our assessment. So for 20 years, now fast forward 20 years, in 2007, there was a big drop in the market. I think everybody's values went down because they went down. I don't think folks got real excited with that assessment 10 years ago because for the most part, our values either held or went down, tax rates remained about the same. Troubling thing is if you look at the slope of the curves, those other neighborhoods, Cottage Lane is going up a tiny bit, but we are projected to go up again. So if you keep this disparity up, I mean, pretty soon, 34 of us are going to be basically funding the entire town. I'm not being facetious there. I mean, you can make a case, you guys can chuckle. You can make a case that over the past 20 years, we've overpaid by about $1.2 million in aggregate.
or an average of about $40,000 a home. But I won't go there. It's water under the bridge. We lost. I accept that. But I'm not going to accept getting stuck in the eye twice. And here's the other really disturbing thing. Robbins Farm is the same age as Giles, exactly. They went in the same time, late 80s. Homes start to depreciate at some point. 30 years is usually about that point. Settlement Circle and Cottage Lane are less than 20 years old. So for Settlement to be going down after less than 20 years and for us to continue to go up with 30-year-old homes, that just defies anything anyone knows, you know, real estate 101.
And all those data points are part of this package?
Correct. Yeah. Correct. Now, I will say this. We only have 4 sales in the Woodlands in the last 2 years, so I had to tap into those. But if you picked 1 sale, or 2, or 3, or 4, if you wanted to go back more than 2 years, if you wanted to go back 4 years, 6, 8, 10, the delta is about the same. It doesn't skew the data. Avatar can pick whatever, you know, but I will ask that if they're going to pick 6 months' worth of sales in our neighborhood, that they pick 6 months' worth of sales in other neighborhoods. That's apples and apples. You know, they can't possibly say, I've got a year, you know, 2017 of sales in all of the neighborhoods, but I'm going to go back 7 years in the Woodlands, you know. Because if they were to do that for both us and the rest of the town, this disparity will continue. It's the same. The more I mine this data, the more it reinforces this basic difference. And the difference is about 20% in assessed sales or 30% in total assessment between us and the rest of the town. So that's it. I would ask that you look at this data, see if you can make sense of it in your minds. I recognize that assessing is,
that's a good chart.
As Mr. Roberge has told us, you know, as much an art as a science.
Did you want to talk about?
Well, pretty much speaks for itself, right? 50% increase in assessment in our neighborhood, 2018-18. So just one other thing to consider. And I know, again, Avatar doesn't want to hear about any of this. But the only sense I could make of this strategy is that you've already got 34 homeowners that are, they're going to come in and abate pretty much for the rest of their lives because most of us are convinced we've been over-assessed since day one. If you apply these numbers right now and you keep the tax rate the same, 1,166 property owners won't have to pay one penny extra to support this town. But 34 of us will have to pay about $150,000 extra a year. If I was a strategist and I wanted to get as few abatements as possible and keep as many people as happy possible, that's the only logic I can think behind that. And I can't wait to hear how they justify what they've done. But that's the only thing I can think of where this would make any sense in any universe. So I'll shut up.
Okay, so I'll turn the lights on then because
yeah,
we're
sure.
Done
yeah.
with the things and I'll check in the
14 minutes. Sorry.
Okay. One, do you have any questions that you'd like to ask and comments to make? And second, are you willing to entertain the possibility of listening to some other three?
Sure,
of course.
Okay. Okay.
We always have public
comments. Okay. So, can I just ask her, what are you considering on page 3? Just so it's clear in my mind, what other high-end homes you're considering?
So I use that term for those greater than $400,000.
Okay.
Assessed value greater than $400,000. And there's quite a few in this town, actually. There's more than people would think. There was a plethora of data there. I stopped at about, I think, 12. The more data I mine, the more the values centered right around 18 and 20% respectively for
everyone else.
Yeah. You already had your appointment with Avatar.
I did.
Can you explain how that process worked?
So that's where that cynical comment came out earlier that said it's already over. They mumbled something about maybe we made a mistake, but you have to be a pretty poor mathematician to make a mistake like that. So
I think the company pretty much has their methods and they've applied them before. If we didn't spend so much time in Concord, you know, 20 years ago, I would be more optimistic that maybe there was some explanation. But none of us got the sense that they were, you know what interest-based bargaining is? Have you guys, you know that term?
No, not
really. Interest-based, you know, you ever dealt any union negotiations?
Yes.
Old style union negotiations would be you as management go in and say, here's what you're getting. And the union was ready for that. And they'd say, no, here's what we want. When in fact, both of you want some value in between. Pretty clear to me that this company doesn't subscribe to that method of dealing. And they've come in with a value that's way up here, hoping that we'll be happy with something that's maybe here or even here. But in fact, I'll speak for myself now. I won't let this thing die. I'll abate and appeal this thing until, you know, if they come in saying we'll give you 95% of that differential back, I won't accept it. It's unacceptable. It's wrong. So the sense I got from Avatar is they're not really taking it all that seriously.
Thank you. On my meeting...
Can I ask you please your name?
Sure. It's Mike Hill, and I'm at 12 River Road.
Just going for a recording secretary. Make sure she has it. Okay? Okay.
So I was involved 20 years ago, too, and the mistake that we made is when we got to the top, what they told
us. What do you
mean the top? We went to the Board of Land and Tax Appeal.
Okay.
They said what you should have done is you should have asked for a reevaluation of the whole town. So we know what to do this time. We won't make the same mistake. When I sat down with Avatar, they said we got the land values wrong. So the land values...
I'm sorry, when you sat down with them this time?
Yeah, said we probably didn't get the land values right. They've got most of the land values at anywhere from $250,000 to $300,000. I'm a real estate agent.
An acre.
You couldn't, for one lot.
2 acres.
Yeah, but those are, but it's 2 acre zoning. You can't have a 1 acre lot. So that, I said, you would never sell it for that. None of the lots would sell for that. I know they won't sell for that. So they're all, I would say every single one of them are $60,000 to $100,000 overpriced. That's where the bulk of it is. It's right in that land. And they said when I went in, I went in with the hired gun, the property tax adjustment guy, the pro at it. He had good data, and they said they were going to look at it again. Now, to me that doesn't mean anything, though. Like Herb said, it depends what they come back with. But that was one common place. I mean, if you go back and look at all the sales in the last 10 years, I'm going to say you won't find a lot that's 2 acres that sold for over $200,000 in Rollinsford unless it's right on the river with great access, you know, or something like that. But that's where I think they really made the mistake. And I think the biggest point here is what Herb said, and maybe to drive it home, is if you take any other set of data, the tax assessment is going up about 18 to 20%. In our neighborhood, it's going up 49. Little houses have gone up, as a real estate agent, they've gone up just as much percentage-wise as big houses have. There's no, if we didn't cross a magic
in your neighborhood.
What I'm saying is our prices have gone up the same as, so if I go in Stockdale Circle, those houses have gone up the same. If I go to Stevens Court, in fact, if you really look at it, the little ones have probably gone up more because there's less of them there and more people can buy those. So supply and demand, there's a lot more people that can buy a $150,000 house than can buy a $400,000 house.
But there is a phenomenon, Mike, you got to accept that at you know, the upper stratospheres of real estate, the 1%ers, right? There's folks that will pay whatever for a property regardless, just because they want
it.
They'll pay above market.
If you look at your data, though, it's correct. I mean, and what he said is you can look at above 400, you can look at whatever you want to look at. The difference is this little circle is up 49%. Everyone else, everywhere else, even if they're big homes, are only up 18 to 20.
But we didn't have any of the ones like I just described that would cause you to say, oh,
you know. That's the part that's really concerning. So that land value is where they actually applied the increase. If you look on the first page of the data I gave you, they didn't, they applied it to the land. It basically doubled the price of the land value. That's how they came up with this new assessment.
We're starting to get some comments from somebody.
Yeah, sure.
Paula Woolley, we're at 117 Woods Run. At our meeting with Avatar, what we pointed out to them was, our question is, how did our land go up 120%? He said, we don't, we wanted this figure and we're not sure how we got to it. So he said, yes, it's incorrect. Can't tell you how we got that and it will be looked at. But that's our concern, is how did our land more than double in value when the rest of Rawlingsford did not.
Anyone else?
Paula, I've been to the river. You're not anywhere near the river, are you?
Me? No.
I didn't think so, okay.
Yeah, we're a quarter, almost a quarter mile from the river.
Okay, let's try to wait until we're addressed and then you can speak, if that's okay with everybody. Yes, sir.
Yep, Rob Roy, 55 Woods Run. I had a meeting here with Ed Jensen just before he left office here in the building. And I had a whiteboard and I showed him all my tax bills since I moved into development in 1996. And needless to say, it's a steady progression upwards with an occasional break to keep the animals at bay, and then it would go right back up again. And he looked at me and he said this, and I quote, he said, "Rob, you realize your properties in the woodlands have been artificially kept high compared to the rest of the town, so you pay a greater share of the taxes." Quote, unquote, that's exactly what he told me. Do you think he was telling the truth?
You know, I don't know how to respond to something that I didn't hear.
Yeah. Okay.
And I do know Mr. Jansen has made some outrageous comments to me, mm-hmm. personally, okay. just to see what I would react, and they're not...
I was stunned. I have to tell you, I was stunned. If that is true, that's corrupt to the core. I'm sorry to say.
Well, understood.
I mean, if it's
not
true,
here,
it's corrupt to the core.
It's a, you know, it's, this point is, I don't know, hearsay, whatever it is. I mean, I'm not doubting you, but we can't respond to that statement,
yeah.
So.
Okay.
Thank you.
I just thought I'd throw it out for the atmosphere.
Yes, sir.
Chris Merrill, 121 Woods Run. I came in on Friday for my assessment mm-hmm. at the end of their long week, I'm sure, and they just about stopped me. We already know this problem, they're looking into it, and they didn't want to talk about it, so we're looking into it. I just wanted to make sure, the assessor I talked to. I want to make sure you guys are aware of the story we're being told, they're looking into it, and they're going to get back to us.
We did get
it. Doesn't just
I'm looking now at an email that came in from them just today. They are, in fact, looking at, I assume, the board.
I don't remember seeing anything from Avatar. I'm not going to lie, so I would lose my town email
it
while that works. I wasn't sure if they were communicating with you, but they communicated.
They did, and they said
that
the neighborhood is worried about the increase in value when compared to the rest of the town. So Jonathan and I will take the time to re-review. I don't know what re-review is, but and make sure we have considered absolutely everything. So the board, you know, after you leave this evening, the board is going to continue with our agenda, but at the end we'll come back to this and we'll see how the board, if the board wants to touch base with after, how the board wants to proceed. So, you know, we may well be also kind of checking in with Avatar. Again, I'm not the board. The board needs to review it and discuss it as a board. So right now we're listening.
Thank
you.
The other thing I was told was it was all skewed because it was based on one thing. And I thought that was odd. And I don't know if everybody else was told the same thing.
We were told the same thing. They used one sale, and that sale is outrageous compared mm-hmm. to the rest of the neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
All right. Thank you. Yes, sir.
Jeff Heron, 43 Woods Run. When was our
Thursday.
So I let them talk for 10 minutes. I asked them to give me the whole spiel, and I said, well, by any measure of high school statistics, you're nothing's flawed. Yeah, I know that. I said, yeah, you know that. So I would asked the selectmen to consider, how does this end? It ends either Avatar is incompetent, and you need to find another company and get the town reassessed immediately, or Avatar is incompetent, and they just didn't do a very good job this time, and they need to redo it. But something's got to be redone. And both of those things, you know, in the end, as Herb has pointed out, it's going to start costing the town money when the lawyers get involved. And I don't really want to see it get that far. The town doesn't have the money to defend itself like that. But, you know, 20 years of abuse is enough. You know, I already spoke to this group a couple of weeks ago. You heard my comments a couple of weeks ago. My opinion is even more negative now, so I'm trying to keep that to a minimum, okay?
Thank you very much.
I would like to address that one sale.
Can I just, Herb, yeah. just a minute, is anybody else who has not spoken would like to add anything?
So you've got this in your package.
Yep.
Flip to the page. It says comparable sales greater than 300K. So
is it just my packet?
Yes. Yes. No, you're the only one that's got that.
So I'm looking for what again?
This sheet right here. Well, you can, if you look at some of those right there.
Right.
The one sale they're referencing was probably the one that I referenced, which was sometimes folks are willing to pay a lot for a house just because they want it. In our case, that was actually, I think it was 2014, it was a few years ago. But if you use that mentality, I can find you two sales right there on that list that were in the last 5 year or 4 year window, where if I picked that value, you look at that delta there, minus 51, minus 54, and applied that same mentality, you'd end up with Robert's Farm probably about 45%. Instead of 20% increase. You see what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
If you could use that cherry picking the one sale mentality, which, so if they're going to apply that mentality, why wouldn't you apply it elsewhere? There's a house that sold in Roberts for $500,000. Was it worth that? Who knows? It is now, but so by any angle, your arguments don't hold up.
I understand. I mean, I understand there's great concern. And anytime you are talking about issues that pertain to your home, where you live, where you bring your children up, where you retire to, it's clearly a big deal. And I understand it to be a big deal, and I'm sure the board understands it to be a big deal. And we appreciate, I mean, this is democracy. This is government in action. So we appreciate your coming here and telling us about this and how you feel. So I see Paul again.
I just have one point to make about Avatar. We had a 3-day window to call them to get an appointment. I spent 2 separate days of a 2-hour time period calling and calling and calling, getting a busy signal, that I finally ended up calling Caroline and said, would you please document that I've been trying to get a hold of them? She sent them an email, and then they called me. But to get a hold of them in itself was not very worker people friendly.
Not user friendly. Okay, thank you for that information. I appreciate it. Anybody else?
I have one more comment related to my Avatar meeting. When I questioned him about the land value going up so high, his response was, this was young Robert. What's his first name?
Chad.
Okay. He said, well, we had to bring the value up somehow. Mm-hmm. We couldn't put the house at $150 or $200 a square foot for the building, because that would be obviously wrong. So we had to do something, right?
That's
when I decided he was an idiot and incompetent, and you guys need to address that, because, you know, I'm being nice. He fully admitted that they have made mistakes in the entire neighborhood, and his flippant attitude was really uncalled for. Now, maybe it's because he'd been abused so many times that day by the rest of the neighborhood, but, you know, it's just, you guys need to find another company to do this.
I appreciate comments. Thank you. Anyone else? All right, so the board.
Thanks for me. Thanks for listening. Thanks for listening.
Well, thank you for coming. Really, again, it's your home, it's your property. I certainly understand, and I know the board understands the feeling behind all of that and what it means. And so I appreciate your coming, and we'll see how the board would like to address it.
Okay, we've been here for 30 years most of us. We're not in the conference.
Hope you have some tomatoes, as I was told. If you're not fourth generation, you're newbie.
That's right.
And Michael's got a baseball.
Could you say your name, please?
Susan Janato, 105 Woods Run. I wanted to know, just how long will it take for you to take this all under advisement and consideration, and how would you get back to us?
Well, it's hard to know. We'll probably discuss it later on in this meeting. My initial response, or my initial thought, is that whatever we decide to do, I'd probably get back to her, who was the point of contact.
Okay.
We may want to touch, I don't know. I don't want to second guess the board. So I
okay,
would like to know.
Okay, we'd like to know.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll keep that posted. You know, one of the biggest concerns is, from last time, once they put that final number on paper, they're done. Right, Mike? I mean, they're done.
Then you have to go to the board.
It was over right there. When they put that final number on paper 20 years ago, when you go to the board and land in tax appeals, they know each other by first name. There was no listening there. It was over. We were dead on arrival.
We don't have to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. Is anybody else for sale?
Before I bought the house.
Nice to see you.
It was 15 acres. Then they reassessed it down to 573. And the tax bill was 15 acres.
Have all wood. They have the
old eventually.
Yes.
All
right, we're gonna continue with the meeting.
The problem is the way they did it. Us at 50%.
Take care of my
control.
Good night. Bye, guys.
So, we're going to continue the meeting, please.
That's the deal. All right, we'll see you later.
See you tomorrow. All
right. But if indeed the land is completely outrageous, like we would look at full contracts, right? Not just that redevelopment.
I think that's what we're going to talk about.
Yeah, because we all got hit that with that on the land. But I felt that this would fit. Thank you. Okay, I am here returning my purchase order for Family Day. There it is. I will give you a copy of the. Oh, you know what? I need something. I'll sign it. I'm sorry.
We take
over
the check. I have on the car. I didn't even hear yet the breakfast yesterday. I didn't have it.
Well, let's do the purchase order, and then we can.
Yeah.
How does that sound?
Okay.
It's not big enough to offset the purchase order, I don't think so.
Okay. And here's a copy of the contract, which I have submitted and made my deposit to Mark. Okay, so this is a copy for us. That is your copy for your files. You can take it to the PO, and we are in pretty good shape.
Oh, that's good.
Yes,
yes. That's really good.
We are definitely going to make the fireworks.
Yes.
So I'm very pleased
about
that.
Jody, would you like to? Sure. Move to accept purchase order 1266 to Old Home Day Family Day Association for one family fun day amount for $500.
For fireworks. Fireworks. I just did, yeah, put it for Old Home Day.
Yeah,
fireworks.
Yeah.
Yep.
Second.
Is there any discussion, questions? Call it. All those in favor say aye.
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 You can have fireworks.
Is the link still active though?
Yes.
Do you pay a fee though if I pay that
yes.
way? All right, so I'll just.
Yes.
Do you want a waiver? I can.
I'm
going to drop it.
I'm going to check the same way.
All right.
Maybe you want.
Maybe you want.
It's okay. If I get tired. Thank you so much. And
thank you,
Caroline. Will just give me a call when it's ready.
Thank you for persevering.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes.
Okay, it's good.
be bigger and better than ever.
And what day is it again, please?
What, I'm sorry?
What day is it again?
September 23rd.
23rd.
Saturday.
No response whatsoever. Yeah, I think you were there for briefly, you know, this thing. Okay, so, we got down to finishing the highway and the transfer station. So we're at the police and the removal of the shed.
Did you hear anything?
I have not heard anything. They came and looked at it. The police let them in, and we have not heard back from them, so.
So it seems like the only person he responds to is Bob, right? This is weird.
Well, he called me.
I'm sorry, did you talk, yeah, okay.
Because one of his guys was gonna be in town and they wanted to look at it.
Okay.
So since we have a lock on it, the police had to let him in. Since then, they have not heard anything.
But Bob was here last week and said that he had heard, that he was still interested?
Yeah, yeah. When you were not here, yeah.
But that doesn't mean that he's following through, so.
It's a mystery, it's like we hear one thing and then we don't hear from him for a while, and so I don't know, if anybody can bring this to some kind of closure, that would be helpful. We still have to write a contract, but I think we don't wanna invest the time until we get to somewhere closer. All right, so.
It might make sense for like a two-pronged attack. Bob reaching out and Jody at the same time, maybe he might respond to one of them, I don't know.
Sure.
I'm not trying to overstep, but I think to his handling as well, it's just, but if he's not responding, he might respond. Bob said he talked, that's the only reason I say that.
Okay, all right. All right, town administration, project updates. So culverts, I was gonna stop by today and then I forgot when I came home instead, so. I believe Willie Street is winding down, I think, although the head walls haven't arrived yet, so I guess the head walls will have to go in place. There have been some hiccups, if you've been keeping up with emails and stuff.
I saw an email, what happened? What?
Hiccups. If I were to give you more detail, I would probably want to go into non-public, so it's up to the board if you want to hear more detail about that.
So,
bottom line is that things get straightened out. We will need full-time construction oversight. Will Tanner is putting together a task order. They found a sub-consultant, so it's not a Will Tanner employee, but it's a professional engineer. And they're going to put together a plan. I was hoping to have it tonight, but I didn't see it. So that they would use the junior person as much as they possibly could. And as far as complexity, from hardest to easiest, it's Pine, Willie, and the Lower Mill. Lower Mill is actually simple. The only issue is that if they find contamination, dig that trench. Yeah, let's hope not. Otherwise, the job itself is really a lot more straightforward. So this was the middle complexity project. And they're gonna go to the Lower Mill next in order to let Pine Street try to dry out as much as possible. I guess that's one of the stratagems there. So we at least know that we'll have oversight. It's going to be expensive. We've got, you know, $30,000 to $32,000 in contingency. So hopefully we'll be able to manage that oversight through that. And otherwise, unless you have questions, if you want to hear more detail, then we can go into non-public.
We should do that. I'd like to do that. Yeah. So when we do the non-public for elderly, maybe we can do it right after.
Yes.
Perfect. Keep coming in.
The other item there is the placeholder to make sure that we fill out the certification after it's Pine Street related. So after they do Pine Street, we need to sign some paperwork for the Army Corps of Engineers. All right, developing policy guidelines on Class 6 roads. We've been working on this with our attorney. He has recommended to us that we look at the Town of New Durham's policy guidelines on Class 6 roads. They're not ordinances, their guidelines to help guide and direct the board in managing permits of that nature. And so what I'm looking for from the board is just an overall sense of, is this a, and you can fully participate in this as we, because, yeah. So do we think that there's merit in that approach and that we can sort of step on that path and follow that? So in other words, we would.
Well, I think you need to close one door before you open another.
What's the door we need to close?
You need to address your property owner that's already asking. Because all the ordinance, all the guidelines that you sent from New Durham, it's all in the Hard Road Travel book. That's word for word from the Hard Road Travel book. It's already out there.
Okay.
So, looking at these guidelines is one thing, but you already have something in the works. So.
Well, I understand, but in order to sort of guide the board to how best to act, it's important for us to have a set of rules, guidelines, whatever we call them, which the board has not had. If the board had these.
You do have them, they're in the Hard Road Travel book.
They're not the town of Rollinsford's guidelines. The town of Rollinsford, the select board of the town of Rollinsford has not adopted them. And that's the issue. So
but the state of New Hampshire has.
Michael, do you
want to
comment?
The state
so I watched your meeting last week. It's very entertaining when you're people. So, and Mike even said, we can't hold one to the other.
What did you say, Michael?
That every, I don't know exactly what I said, but probably that the applicant that's currently before us wouldn't necessarily, I don't remember exactly what I said, but wouldn't be, shouldn't be held up while we wait on doing this. I think we can do them simultaneously, but it doesn't mean that, just because we haven't adopted this doesn't mean we can't act on the other one, on the application that, well, we can't offer guidance on whether or not we would issue a building permit in that case, and we can set stipulations, and they can be right from this, because we're empowered to do that by statute. But I think what Suzanne is saying, and I think it's really important, because separate from this one instance, we have several other Class 6 roads that potentially could be developed or not. Some probably should not. So we should have a set of guidelines that guides us in making that
or
that
future
decision.
Boards, not
yeah.
just this. Oh,
right.
I totally agree.
Yeah.
Yeah. But these guidelines are exactly from the Hard Road Travel book. If you could, they cut and pasted it just for your reference.
I understand. There are many, many things in Hard Road,
totally
whatever,
fine.
And in books on budgeting and other
yeah.
kinds of things. But until a town examines a set of suggestions, recommendations, whatever,
mm-hmm.
we're empowered to do what's in that book. We don't have to do it. I mean, so, like, for instance, right now, our zoning ordinance says we don't build on Class 6 roads. That's it. No gray area. You just don't do it. Well, obviously we don't do, because we have. So, but we don't have any written policy, so it's such a haphazard process. It's
so
a disservice to the applicants, and does a disservice to the board, it does a disservice to the rest of the town, I think. So I think we need to get this settled. And it doesn't have to be done, it can be done simultaneously if we work through the other. The issue on Cheney Lane, for example. Right? I mean, what we've said before, we can do both at the same time.
I guess.
I like these guidelines.
So I don't think it's going to take us long then, if we are generally in agreement with the guidelines, to sort
of,
you know, when is the next planning board meeting?
September 5th.
Is it possible to get these on that agenda? And if either you could speak to them or Steve Roberts can speak to them and provide a background on that? So, I mean, I think what he was suggesting, let me see if I can get this. Your concern is it's gonna take us too long to do it, is that?
I just think you're trying to create a policy while you're trying to solve a problem.
Precisely, that's it, that is precisely it.
But you can't do that to the resident, you have to give them an answer.
Well, the answer is you can't build on a class six road.
Yeah, you can.
Well, there's nothing that says.
You can if you get certain waivers from the planning board or the ZBA.
And if we're talking about that specific case, then you have to recuse yourself, I'm afraid.
But if it was any other case in town, I would say the same thing.
But it's not, but it's not.
Fair enough.
It's not.
So, you're.
So. So, he said, please review the attached copy and let me know if this is the direction we want to go. If so, I would then work with the planning board to have it review and provide its recommendations to the Board of Selectmen on policy. The Board of Selectmen would also have a public hearing before any formal vote of adoption. While this process may not be strictly needed, I think it best to be as public as possible in developing the policy for Class 6 roads. In order to enable the public to weigh in on what how they feel this guidance should be. So if, I'm not sure that Steve has to go to the planning board, but we can ask him if that's best, and we can see if we can get him on the agenda. We can get a public hearing date on the calendars.
So do you wanna do that next week, the 28th? So it'll be ready for planning?
The public hearing would come after planning, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
It goes to planning board first.
And they could give their input.
And they could give their input, and then we would announce that at the public hearing, and then we'd have the public hearing. So let me bring up my calendar. So the planning board would be meeting September when, Michael?
Yeah.
Okay.
And they have to Labor
Day?
Unless they've postponed it, I haven't seen anything.
I haven't seen anything posted.
So we could tentatively schedule a public hearing for the 11th. I may not be here.
So
the 12th?
Here, we're canceling the 11th.
Well, I knew that was going to happen, I heard Michael say earlier this evening.
And where I said there's a week in September and there's a week in October. Maybe in Washington.
So we could. So I can't make it the 12th, I can't make it the 13th. There's a school board meeting on the 14th. We could do it Monday the 18th. Okay. So I'm just going to write it on my agenda. So tentative public hearing. I will get in touch with Steve and see if he feels the need to come to the planning board to review all of that. It might not be a bad thing. Can you remind me of the date? By what, 18th?
May 18th.
Thank you. And the planning board is?
The 5th.
It's also at 6:30?
Maybe at 7.
Maybe at 7, okay. All right. As long as I was copying on this. Oh, it is warm in here, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't feel like
it's
hot at all. 73.
Okay. All right, so I think we have a pathway. We have a pathway, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, excellent. Thank you. Right to know request. So we've got a request from Mr. Egan. Caroline is working on the invoices and on any of the reviews that we received. There were only two that we received from Avatar on current use, so we'll collect that. When I have the emails that I've received, I'll put them in a folder and send them to you. Most of mine is the whole board, so you wouldn't have to. Did you already check?
I didn't have any.
You didn't have anything directly to you? You don't have any? Oh, okay. All right. So when they're there, I'll let you guys know. if they're there, you can take a look at them. Caroline, I think, may have some stuff, you know, just, she sometimes does administrative back and forth, so she may add to that. You saw the guidance that we received from the Municipal Association. If they're not our records, we don't have any of their, we're not in possession, we don't have any of their notes or field notes or anything like that, so.
We could feel, find out though if we had adopted their policies or something, as I know it said, from legal inquiries, said that if we at one time may have adopted their guidelines or ours, because we're the assessors, we contract out to a company to do it for us. And I don't know if they ever did, so if they did, and that would be the case where we would need to turn them off. So I'm going to just get over here. Right now.
I think what they said is, if we ask them to create those documents, to create field review documents, then we would make them available. But we did, you know, we didn't.
We didn't direct them. I'm saying our predecessors may have. That's why I just want to make sure. It doesn't make the window. Maybe it's the best bet.
I'm going to see you Thursday night. I can get to you.
Okay.
No.
I just turned off and we got the window open.
Someone needs to learn how to use it.
It's on. It's not.
I don't see that language that you're referring to, Michael.
It's just what you read, Suzanne. If we asked.
Can't put it on 55.
It's getting cooler.
It is getting cool, a little cooler.
The window's open.
Oh.
I'm assuming that's what I want.
It may be sufficient with the window.
Why don't you open Caroline's office and open that window and it gets across ventilation?
Is that window easy to close? I know this is a bear. Close.
She has a screen. This one's a bear.
Sure, no bats fry in here.
She wasn't sure, she was asleep, so the doctor recommended her.
She didn't know when she got bit.
She couldn't. She wasn't going to take the chance. She's a doctor, she don't care. She's a doctor, she don't care.
Says they were created by Avatar, a private company, in the course of performing its work. They were never provided to the town, they were not. I don't think they are governmental records. If, however,
I'm suggesting, how do we know they were never provided to us? I guess that's my question.
Well, they didn't, what do you mean they were?
They could have been provided to us years ago, I guess at that point.
He's only asking for records from January
3rd. The system that the town doesn't have to work.
But I thought he wanted the process by which they do the assessing. Not the question. I have in front of me. I apologize. I just want to make sure we provide all the information the requesters are requesting. That's all.
Number one, please produce all current guidelines in whatever format held to the field review process for the evaluation of current use properties.
We don't hold any of that information.
If you know something that
I don't know, then
I can say,
okay,
we don't have.
I think we can say we don't have a copy of that.
Yeah, if we have to know what they are and where they are, we surely don't.
Okay.
Please produce full, complete, and accurate copies of all field reviews conducted in Rawlsford from January 1st to the present date, indicating the date the field review was conducted. So we do have in our possession the two letters that they were sent to us, the result of their field review.
Okay.
So we'll make those two letters available. One was to Mr. Dips, one was to Mr. Peavy. Okay. Please produce copies of all correspondence in whatever format created or held from Avatar. Caroline is in, I'm looking at the stuff that come that came to us. I'll PDF it, put it in a file. Caroline is looking at her own. She's going to check in with the front office, and we'll think about any paper copies of anything that we might have received that would be part of them. Please produce all invoices. That's easy. So she was also going to try to contact them. We don't know that they've been contacted yet.
Who's they?
The Megans.
Yeah. Okay. A message was left for them.
Is that from Andrea? See, Andrea was not in today, so
it
I don't.
Was from Kate, actually, because Kate was the one who was also CC'd on the letter, so she called.
Okay.
The number's unlisted, so
right.
I couldn't personally call.
So
they have a number.
Caroline was going to follow up to if he had not been contacted, she was going to contact him. So we are, and that to let him know that we are in the process, which we are.
Perfect.
Any other comments, questions on that? MS 535, we don't have anything to look at yet, so just leave it at that. When we were talking about credit cards, maybe it was when Jody was here, maybe it was just with you, Mike, but a question came up with regard to a reimbursement for Chief Ducharme for something that was more than 200, and whether we wanted to, because some online purchases are just cheaper at Amazon, but we have no mechanism of doing that. If we wanted to increase Caroline's upper limit, and we could consider like the upper limit of the limited purchase orders that is in that the purchase order under review, and that way, if you were a department head, there would be the two people looking at it. So
how much? I don't remember how much Bob's was last week. It was under 500, right? If I remember correctly.
Yes.
So
I don't know how much. I mean, it's 400 in the current pending, we could just try that, we could make it 500,
So the current limit is 400?
In a policy that we haven't formally adopted. The credit card limit is set by us, it's not a bank controlled. The bank controlled is overall for the town, and overall for the individual, I think it's $1,000. All right, it could be two. Yeah. Individually, right.
Now, you're just saying you didn't know how much you had left in a month. That's why you were doing the purchase order.
I don't think it's per month, though. I think it's... I need to check what that limit is. I'm not sure how to describe it at this point.
All right.
So I'm just bringing it forward because someone suggested it was either you, Jody, or you, Mike.
Oh, it was last week with Chief Ducharme. So
okay.
If he was getting, I don't remember what it was.
And he needed to be reimbursed because. Okay.
There has to be at least one that has a higher limit than $200 because there are going to be those.
Yeah, so the question is what limit would you like it to have and does it seem feasible to make it even more?
That would make the most sense.
And if she's doing it on behalf of the town, she would be doing it under our auspices.
Right.
So, and otherwise it would be with the department head and it would be two people.
Yeah.
So what is the question?
The chief could have just come in, if she had $500, just say for sake of argument, he could have got his $450, $65, whatever it was.
$614.
But, so.
Right, without having to have it be on his credit card.
Right.
Correct.
And if it's over that, well, then he still has to.
Yeah. We're not going to solve all. We're not going to solve all bills. Does the board want to consider that?
Yeah.
Does the board want to move? When we do that
right
now.
I'll move up to $500.
Okay.
So $500.
All right. So I'm going to try for Salma's record keeping. I think what I heard is a motion to raise Caroline's credit card limit to $500 for the purpose of working with department heads for purchases. No more than $500, and with regard to purchases that the board asked her to do on our behalf, no more than $500.
I mean, if it's just an internal policy, I mean, if the card really has like a $2,500 limit or whatever, then I'm guessing it just doesn't.
No, this would be an internal.
Okay.
This doesn't get any of the hard bank-related things, though. One of which is easy to change anyway, and I don't remember which one, the other one of which is difficult.
What I'm saying is, I think it was over 500 last week, so if we wanted to say, okay, in this instance, we would want you to use the card because we're gonna get a better rate for the item we're purchasing.
Yes, we could do, yes, we could do that, yes.
We could make exceptions if we need to.
Yes, good point, yes, we could do that. But it's a convention, so she doesn't have to.
Well, if that's the case, then I guess I wasn't understanding that, maybe we don't need to do this, and I guess I was misunderstanding.
Well, do we want Caroline to check her limits every time she has? I mean, this, now I'm misunderstanding you, are you saying you want the board to be checked in on for any, for all of these things?
Oh, for larger purchases, yeah, for a $500, $600 purchase, I would think so, yeah.
Right, so the 400 is what we were talking about.
Right.
Which is the threshold for the limited purchase order that is part of the policy and development.
I got you.
So, and then 500 came up in this motion, which is currently on the table. So, do we want to retract that?
Well, we've moved and seconded, right, so we can at least discuss it.
Yeah, that's what we're
doing. So, is it, I might be confusing myself, and I apologize. Is it even necessary then? If the card has an upward limit that could be higher than the 200, if we needed it to be, we could just make that on a case-by-case determination. If Bob came in again this week and said he needed another 615 for something, and he wants to be reimbursed, we could just say, no, we're going to put it on the town's credit card, and then pay it, and just pay it right off, instead of having to have him pay it, and then cut a check to him. Can that happen now?
Yes, I think what we're trying to do is eliminate this. I mean, you know, so on Tuesday, he's done his research for such and such,
right,
and it's $425, and it's on Amazon, and so he comes to Caroline, or $375, he comes to Caroline.
Okay.
And so the two of them can execute this on Tuesday or Wednesday or Thursday or Friday.
As long as we have the upper limit.
And congratulations, because you've got me there too.
Perfect.
And I don't know if Jody's right there with us.
I'm following right along.
Come along for the ride.
I was watching the show.
So
it's currently, by this conversation, at 500. You could bring it back down to 400. We can just cancel this one.
Yeah, I don't really have the authority to. Like, one of the things that they had to use for the credit card was the piping for culverts over at the transfer station. Mm-hmm. They had to go two different times. Or they had to come to us. We have to give them trust at some point. And we're double checking the credit card, but we're wasting more time and energy cross-checking. Like,
yes.
I would much rather have the pipe be bought that we know was being worked on, and drive there once, than to drive there twice.
Okay. We're trying to set up policies that make sense, that allow us still to control and to make sure we're following and being responsible, without creating a lot of extra activity on our part or their part.
Right.
So right now,
because the work won't get done that day. And they don't have the material they need.
Or it will get done, and they'll just come to us after the fact. One of the things we're trying to do.
That's not going to happen with highway.
One of the things we're trying to do is make sure that for those purchases that are above that threshold, that they come to us before.
Right.
That we're not supposed to be signing an authorization to pay.
So I'm going to rescind my motion. Why don't we just keep it 400 then?
All right. So I'm not a parliamentarian. So do we just say the motion is rescinded and go on?
Yeah.
All right, so that motion is rescinded. Would you like to put another one on the table? You don't want to do the 400? You don't want any of this?
No, I'm fine with just sticking with the $400 level that we have worked on previously.
That policy is in development.
Okay.
So what we're, so yeah, so I, so that's why I was looking for some motion that says at least the board. In other words, we're adopting a sort of a part of the policy that we haven't fully adopted. And that is for credit card purchases, we will allow Caroline to spend up to $400 in conjunction with a department head for purchases.
Okay. So.
Second.
Did you get that, Salman? All right. All those, All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Congratulations, I think we got there. Thank you. We were discussing that so long, I got logged out. All right, Old Mill Lane Bridge is a placeholder on the table. SB 38 appropriate account use of funds.
When's the hearing, Bill? I forgot to ask you.
We had our friends, Charlie and Nancy, and Salma, who was our recording secretary.
It was 3 minutes.
So, yes, and so later on in that evening, the board, Jody and I, agreed to accept the funds.
Okay.
They're already sitting in our bank account.
Perfect.
So Caroline has set up a meeting, is trying to set up a meeting, it's not set up, with me and Tom.
Okay.
And Caroline, to talk about, how do we, what account do we, what kind of an account do you want us to set up?
Tom do that.
Yeah, which is the guidance that was provided in those letters we got from DOT. Talk to your auditor, figure out the best way to do it. They are non-lapsing funds.
Perfect.
So we will have access to them.
And we didn't come to any conclusion as to how we'd like to spend the funds?
No, the general thought is that we are just, right now, for the moment, carrying them forward.
Okay.
And part of it's gonna be used to pay for the oversight of.
If need be.
Gotcha.
Yep.
Because we're worried about how to pay for the.
We have $32,000 in contingency, so.
Right, but remember you were stressing that night.
Yeah, because, you know, and also it's disappointing, because, you know, you know, it's just disappointing too, because you say, huh, look, you know, we make them in our budget by $32,000.
And then we open it.
And there was nothing that we could pave this time of year for that without being a driveway.
Yeah, it's just not a good time of year. People are already booked, so we could pay top dollar, you know, it's, so.
Exactly. Fortunately.
Okay. And, I mean, there's the issue of the backhoe, but I, you know, my guess is because, you know, this is non-lapsing, we will have time to think about it during budget prep.
Yeah.
Does that work with everybody? Review transfer station fees, I think that,
Oh, yeah, I think I sent that, to talk about this time of year, because they're gonna be selling transfer station stickers in a couple months.
So do you want us to look at the, cost of the stickers? Do you want us to look at the fees that are charged? How would you like to start this process? Do you all have the transfer station ordinance with the fees? And we don't have Jeff, so I don't know how you wanna.
I was just thinking more of, well, the fees themselves are in line with other towns right now.
Okay, you mean the, so the, our disposal fees are okay? All right, so that's not what you mean then?
And then enforcing those is one issue that will have to address the management.
Yeah.
The second issue is the sticker itself. So, we're not breaking even. So we pay a lot in hauling and stuff like that, and we're hoping with the second canister that will help, but we have, it's definitely offsetting, where people that create a lot of trash, such as my family, is having very little to pay for.
Proportionally.
To
me, for example.
Exactly.
Maybe, I do composting, I do this and that, and whatever, let's just say, I'm not.
You don't have to.
And we're just two.
Diapers thrown around.
Yeah, right, exactly, there's, right.
Yeah. So.
Or single, or retired, single.
Right.
Person.
My mom, who lives alone now, so. My mom.
Okay.
But, yeah.
So you're thinking of trying to think about a new stratagem, a different way to manage the stickers?
Well, actually, the gentleman that was here tonight, who was gone, that came to me at town meeting last year or the year before, I forget, and had recommended, like, under 65 be one fee and over 65 be another fee. Now, I mentioned that to Kate last year, and she said that that would be too hard to manage, but she has to take the resident tax anyway, and that goes by age too.
All right, but so let me ask you, how, if you think we're not breaking even now, how are you anticipating breaking even if, are you saying we raise it from $10 for everybody except people over 65? Do we keep it at 10 for people over 65?
Yeah.
All right, and do you want to recommend to the board?
I would say 20 or 25. You pay a dollar a bag or more in Dover.
Well, why not consider the paper bag? Because
well,
that
the cost
that,
of getting them that, because they have curbside pickup.
So. There are towns though with like us that sell the bags, and the I'll send you the link. The town and city, they did an analysis of this a couple of years ago, and you know the argument is that just it's really user fee based. You generate a lot of garbage, you're going to pay more.
Right.
Somebody doesn't generate as much.
Right.
So and they had some. I'm not going to be able to. They have statistics. I'm happy to send you the link if you want to look at that again. Would you like that? I could do.
Oh, we have.
Yeah. If you can do your own research, that would be lovely too. But it I guess it's in the archives. You can find it online. It was transfer station user fees. Different ways to manage it. So that I mean, it's an interesting thing. And I like it because it's user based. So if you are generating a lot of trash, you pay more. You have to buy the bags.
How does the board feel about that?
Having
Yeah, having the conversation. I'd like to refresh myself and look at that article again.
Okay.
But, you know, that's certainly nobody then is looking at over 65 or under 65, but presumably if you're over 65 and, you know, not as active as you used to be, maybe, you know, you have less
garbage.
Yeah. All right, well, that's a good next step.
It's like Dunkin' Donuts, you get the senior citizens. But I thought
this
conversation should be had now.
Yeah,
no,
that's a great idea. Yeah, absolutely.
She's selling the stickers.
Absolutely, because we always seem to be a day late and a dollar short on it. I agree. So review an article, and when I find it, I'll just send you a link. It's over.
It's over. We all survived.
Yay, guys. Yay, rec committee. Yay, counselors. Yay, directors, assistant directors.
So, Dee sent out a SurveyMonkey to the staff.
Okay.
They're going to be sending out a SurveyMonkey to the families, but I've not received mine
yet.
Excellent.
Good idea.
The last week, they did have a snafu. They lost water because of Willie.
Mm-hmm. That was, as you can see, that was one of the issues.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
I did get those text messages while on vacation.
Yeah, sorry about that.
They took a field trip that day. Unfortunately, they did not notify all the parents that day. So we had a lot of angry parents. They posted it on Facebook, but they didn't send out an email or text message, which they had the ability to.
Where did they go?
They just went to the Dover Park, where the new water splash pad is. So the parents, they didn't have their shirts. The parents weren't notified. And when they went to pick them up at 3 o'clock, no one was there. So,
yeah.
And I was on vacation, and I'm getting all the text messages as they're coming through, and I'm like, oh. So.
Well, thank you for managing
that.
That was, thank you.
And then they were going to bring in porta potties if the water wasn't instilled in time. So I don't know if they did or not.
There was one there. I was there on Thursday.
There was?
There were two.
I was
not. They did? Okay. So, because their other option was to send everybody home.
No, I understand. So you have to, you do what you have to do.
Right. So, in months of chaos, they kept kids safe and everything.
Mm-hmm.
One snafu.
Yeah.
Major snafu, but.
It was a communication snafu as opposed to a safety snafu, I guess.
Right.
So.
I understand. I only got one parent response that was very upset. Other than that, no other responses for that. But now we're on to basketball. I reached out to Cassie Foss. Cassie Foss moved on to the middle school, said to contact Andrea Anderson. I contacted Andrea. Andrea said she'll be the point person for now, but she's going to pass it on to whoever is now taking over basketball. So.
Okay.
That's our next. We have a meeting on Sunday, and we'll be going over everything, and final numbers should be coming in, but because of the extra field trip this week. One extra field trip? just one extra field trip. They only went Wednesday extra.
I don't think they're meeting again until September.
Oh, that's not next week, sorry. The Sunday after Labor Day, we meet. I'm a week ahead, so.
That's actually a couple weekends, I think. I don't know. I'm all confused.
It's the Sunday after Labor Day.
I'm completely confused, so whatever.
All right, well, you know,
clearly, I'm just delighted that we had a rec program, summer rec program. I thank every single person on the rec committee, all of the counselors, the staff, you know, Jody, you for being our point person and helping moving this completely along.
And you heard about Sam's bike?
Yes, I forgot, but.
So Sam, one of our counselors, got his bike stolen while they were on a field trip. So, great kid, great counselor, everybody loved him. All of the counselors pitched in and money to buy him a new bike.
That was just amazing.
And I sent you the little video that they sent me because I was away.
A video?
It's on your, I sent it to your cell phone.
I probably didn't.
You texted it.
Okay, all right, I better go back and check.
Okay, so. So.
And do I have to attend to it, or is it just going to make me feel good?
It'll make you feel good.
Okay, good. I like that.
Yeah.
I'll look at it.
So it's a happy moment. So,
So, and it was of comparable value. I mean, Sam feels okay about.
Sam is happy, or his mother says he was happy about it. I haven't seen him.
Okay.
So,
and we did report it.
It was reported. The school has surveillance of the front and the back, but they don't have it up the sides.
And that's where the
bike
was.
So they're hoping, yeah. So they're hoping that they have the person going
something.
In and out and the police are working on it.
Yeah.
Okay.
So.
And is part of the upcoming meetings that you're going to have sort of a review, lessons learned? Kind of?
I can I'll send Caroline an email if she can type me something.
Yeah,
sure.
I know that she has some ideas,
yeah.
And you have some ideas about sort of administrative interface and back and forth with money and that sort of thing, I think. So,
yeah.
Great. Well, thank you, all of you. Greatly appreciate
now
it.
Basketball.
And now on to basketball. Very good. Let's see. Publishing the zoning ordinance. So, finally, hallelujah. Zoning ordinance is ready to go on the website. So, I'm checking with the board to see if the board has any objections to our putting zoning ordinances on the website. Okay. The other thing, so we'll have a little blurb, you know, so it'll be on the news thing, but it'll stay, it'll have a permanent home somewhere on the website. And nonetheless, if somebody wants a hard copy, it's like over 100 pages, so we're not gonna.
We need at least ten copies. We should have at least 9 copies. We should have one extra in case one wants to buy one. But
4.
One for each member of the planning board. One for each member of the select board.
I don't want to print a copy.
Okay. Actually, we need more than that. We need one for each member of the ZBA and the alternates. I can't remember how many there are. Didn't we just get an email with them?
Can't we just send them the link and say if you want to print a copy, please check with Caroline?
Well, this at least one of the planning board members is also on the ZBA, so we want less.
For example, Michael, seriously.
Each member of the planning board has to have a physical copy so they can refer to it at meetings. Unless, if there isn't a single member of the planning board that arrives with a laptop, with any of us, except for the person taking the minutes. So we need a copy.
I would still, if you would indulge me, like to send an email that says, just let us know. So we're not, you know, it's 100 some odd pages.
Mm-hmm.
And so, but what I am going to come back to the board with regard to printing these is that, you know, it's not correct to charge the standard dollar copy if somebody does want it from you. Obviously, the planning board and CB, if they want a copy, they'll have the copy, no charge. So, but if somebody wants the entire thing printed,
mm-hmm.
I think I just asked Tom. I said, "So, what does Gopher charge?" He said, "I don't know, $10 or $15." So, what?
It would be. I don't know. So, currently we charge $10, or we were charging $10. And this was this one, this copy's from 2001.
Do you want to continue charging 10, you want to charge 15?
I think we should figure out what it costs to have them printed and bound, and then,
I wasn't sure that we're gonna bind them. I think if somebody asks us for a printed copy, we just print them, we attach them.
So, people that are at meetings, need to
our
have,
folks,
need
yes,
to have
yeah,
a bound
our copy. Folks, yes. I'm not talking about our the copies for the folks. I'm talking about the general public.
Mm-hmm. Well,
have
print on demand.
He wants everybody to have an updated copy, which they do not.
Correct.
I've been at a point.
Nobody does.
Exactly.
They do not have all the same book.
Right.
So they all need to be on the same book.
Yes.
To be on the same page.
Quite literally.
Yes. So,
yes.
So we need to do that.
We'll do that. We'll just do it.
But since
we'll
we have to
spiral
buy them, you might as well make a couple of extra copies, have them ready to be sold.
But
much?
Not a lot, because
not a lot.
Yeah,
because
no.
not a lot of extra copies, because we will have updates from year to year, so
correct.
They'll be thrown out. But one or two physical
yes.
hard copies, I wouldn't do more than that. And then you can print on demand after that.
Mm-hmm. And the cost? Should we do 15? Should we do 12?
Well, I don't honestly know, because I don't know how much they're going to cost. Are we going to just go to Michelle or DMD Printing, that we use for the town report or anything, and a newsletter or anything, whatever she charges, and we want to make a, you know, cover the administrative costs, right? So is that $10? Is it 15? Is it 20 now? I also don't know, Suzanne, so I don't want to set a number that's
well,
going to be too
okay.
little.
I'll see if Caroline has any thoughts on that. She can make a recommendation to the board about cost. In the meantime, I want to tell her that we're looking for copies for us.
And ZBA, please.
Yes. All right. Let's see. Oh, so the joint loss safety committee has recommended AED and CPR training. So Caroline asked me, is that mandatory or voluntary? Because I've asked her to let the employees know, and so I'm coming back to the board because I don't know the answer to the question.
Mandatory.
It's mandatory for all employees?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Employees, okay. So then we would be paying them, yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think we had this conversation before. But.
Yeah. Oh, all right, I'm sorry.
No,
I just
to remember everything. That's not what I'm reading, but I think that's why I'm saying I think I know the answer, but I think we talked about it before.
All right, thank you. So I'll have send some letter out to the staff to alert them. All right, utility assessment method. Caroline has arranged a meeting for me and herself and Chad about utility assessment and one other. Maybe it's just utility assessment. To answer some of the questions I had. And she did say today, I'll just bring this up to the board. She said that the assessment could vary depending on whether we had service agreements with other users of the poles. Okay? So for example, the assessment is only charged to Eversource, right? And other folks use the poles. Cable,
yes.
Telephone. Well, maybe no, it's Fairpoint, it's not.
Fairpoint owns the
poles, sorry. But other people use it.
Correct.
So if we had service agreements with these other users of the poles, it would change the assessment. We could actually have a larger assessment. So I'm going to try to get the details on that, the pros and the cons. What does it mean? What is it, you know, what do we have to do? And then I'll report to the board. Or if it's really complicated, I'll have Chad come and talk to the board directly. Does that seem like a good approach?
Yeah, especially he's coming in. So.
Pardon?
Yes.
Yes, well, we haven't gotten there yet. He may well be. Okay. All right, anything on the historical committee, non-lapse account?
We're not meeting this month. We're punting until September.
All right, and anything on job descriptions for joint loss?
Yes, they're due the 18th of September.
the October meeting.
So.
And Mr. Ducharme's gonna work on that.
So, I didn't miss what you just said. Just talking about your office.
No, that's okay. So joint was met, two, three weeks ago there. Job descriptions, are gonna, like Caroline will make points for her job description.
So each person's gonna.
Andrea's gonna make points for hers. They're all gonna filter to Mr. Ducharme, Chief Ducharme, he offered to.
Gotcha.
Point that, type up something nice.
And that was the starting point where we look at.
Mm-hmm.
Is he gonna, so, I mean, I like the road agent one that you, got from Northwood.
Northwood, yeah. I love that. Yeah.
That's,
yeah, that was
really, I thought it was a good one.
No reason to reinvent the wheel.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So.
So.
Does he have a copy of that?
I will send it to him just in case I haven't.
Okay.
Yeah,
I mean, I liked it. I mean, I didn't look at it to see, you know, that carefully to see if the things we wanted to add or cross out, but essentially it was a pretty good one.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So thank you for getting hold of that. All right. Anything else on the job descriptions? Okay. Policies and procedures, the question is, do we want to set out another time to continue the work that we've done? Or, well, there's no or, do we want to?
I think probably should.
Yes.
We're halfway through.
Yeah.
Are we? Do we get that far? That's good.
I think so.
Let's say we went halfway.
All right, let's say.
It would be good to complete our
mission. This next Monday at 6?
Yeah, we're calling it up there. Let's see. That's the 28th, isn't it?
We got quite a bit done, I think, in the half hour the last time.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that worked for me.
Does that work?
What do you
want to
do?
All right, that's next Monday, 9:28. Okay, 6 o'clock, we'll get the notice out.
Okay.
It'll be noticed as a workshop.
Yeah.
And then we'll go into the regular meetings. That would be lovely. All right, town administration standing items. Of course, the first thing I was going to tell you is that I won't be here on September 11th.
Makes two of us.
And Michael won't be on September 11th. So
you
let's look at the.
Just make my day. I'm so excited.
Well, wait a minute. Let's not get too excited because.
We're not meeting
on the 4th because it's Labor Day.
Mm-hmm.
So, are we able to meet on the 12th? This is a really bad week for me.
I'm able to meet Labor Day if we have to. Because it's the end of the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how.
I don't come back until the 13th. So
okay.
I can go to the 14th if you want.
It's a school board. The only problem is that I'm fine with that. It's a school board meeting.
On what?
On the 14th.
Unless if you want to meet on the 12th or the 13th, I won't be working hard with that.
12th, I have continuing yet. I can do that. Wednesday, I can do.
Yeah, and I have a garden club meeting, so I can't do it. I can do the 14th.
I cannot do the 14th.
I can't do the
14th. Okay, our recording secretary can do it. Well, let's go. Look, can we look at the week of the 4th? Can we look at the week of the 4th?
Sure.
So, I could do the 5th.
Plenty more than that, man.
All right, 6th.
The
CIP committee is meeting that night. Aren't
all
you?
Right, yay.
Okay,
I was
going to tell you that next.
I can do the 7th.
I can do the 7th.
Maybe.
I don't know. I'm assuming I can do the 7th. Can you do the 7th?
Well, here's it's a Thursday.
Well,
you can't do it.
Mike's going to be at 2 meetings, so, you know, as long as there's 2 of us.
You can do Tuesday night on the, I don't know what's on the planning board agenda.
Would you mind meeting in the planning board?
Well, that's what I'm going to say. We might be able to meet in there. I don't know what we have for, I don't think we have.
Oh, you have publics. You have,
I would rather not do Tuesday. It's the first day of school.
The 5th, you would
rather
have. Okay.
So, I have no idea what they're going to be doing homework.
They don't start public medicine. That must be nice.
All right, let's look for the first day where there are 2 of us. How does that sound?
Say that again, I'm sorry.
Let's look for the first day after Labor Day where we have 2 of us. Okay? So the 5th,
We don't?
No.
Okay. The sixth?
You don't.
I can.
Sixth?
I can.
I can.
CIP's meeting that night, but I don't know if we're gonna meet the whole time.
So, and you, okay, so let's, shall we go for the sixth?
Do a twofer.
Okay.
You're gonna do 6:30?
Yeah.
You know?
Why always do 6:30?
Well, I don't know, you might want to start earlier, pick a different night.
No, I prefer to, I think it's easier. So Salma, can you make it?
On Wednesday, I can.
Yes, so that's, we said the sixth, Wednesday the sixth? Wednesday nine, six, 6:30, okay. And it will be right now, Jody and Susie.
I'll be there too, when it's done. We're not meeting all night during the CIP stuff.
What time does the meeting start?
Six.
Oh, six, okay, right, who knows?
Well, we'll start in a small one.
And no meeting on the 11th or the 4th?
Correct. So we'll get that all out in one.
That's not a bad idea.
One notice, okay, alright.
So just so you know then, so everyone's planning ahead. My dad has to go back to Washington, October 15th through the 19th. So I'll be gone now, October 15th through the 19th.
19th.
So the 16th, you're all on your own. Actually, I'm being beautiful, but that's, I'm even gonna have to go to Washington.
Yeah, I haven't quite caught up. So no meeting on Labor Day or on 9/11. And the following Monday also you won't be here?
But you had a national holiday, that wasn't a national day every night, so. So.
Maybe.
What, Columbus Day? Don't they close the post office?
Yeah.
So I'm sorry, so Michael, the other thing you just, I didn't get the other thing you just told me.
I'm away October 16th, I won't be here either. That meeting, October 16th, just for planning purposes.
That's not Columbus Day, that's the Monday after.
That's the Monday.
That's the week after Columbus Day.
Okay, you'll have to tell us as we get closer, thank you for that.
Okay.
But.
Throwing it out there for you.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put it in the calendar, and then it's gonna be like, what, I can't wait for it here.
I might go together, I might not be able to get stuff together.
Alright. Alright, so I think we got that squared away, we'll get those notices out.
Alright.
Any other board activities, updates that we should be knowing about? That we didn't already talk about tonight?
CIP meeting on the night, on the sixth, 6 PM, in the small room over there, planning room. And the historical committee is looking for.
We got Lamprey, I got Rec, but I'm trying to time it. I'll drive down there tomorrow morning. If he gets here at 7, I'll be there at 7, and see if I can talk to them for 10 minutes and.
Or just get his, I don't know his phone number, but maybe Caroline has a contact. Or maybe she said he doesn't like to be called at home, I don't know.
Wayne does not like to use his cell phone, because he doesn't want to use his phone at 7. So, we don't have a second cell phone.
Correct.
With the same number that he can forward. Another guy in the car, he do this.
Alright, I just hate to have you get there at 7 and he's not, you know.
Well, if he's not there, I don't know.
Even though it's supposed to, I don't know. Call me. So, I'm not gonna go make trouble for Steve. Just let us know if there's anything we can do to help Caroline to move.
Yeah, and I have a doctor's appointment tomorrow afternoon, so hopefully he's still at work by the time I get out. If that'll catch me in the morning, I'll catch him on the way out, hopefully.
Alright, very good, thank you so much. Any other activities or, things you know about? Alright, then we go right to build our folder work, so building permits. And then we'll talk a little bit about what's wrong.
Veterans tax credit deal.
Yes, we're gonna go into non-public for that at the end.
Is that, or is that the elder, it says elderly for online schedule?
That's my folder.
Oh, so we're doing both at the same time, perfect. Okey-dokey, so the first thing we have, reviewed by Mr. Clark and already stamped by the town, is a septic design for 53 Rollins Road. That's taken care of. And we also have the same thing, just gonna do that. Septic design for 38 Wentworth Street, also reviewed by Mr. Clark, and stamped by the town. Okay, so the first building permit we have is 2017-070, 30 Wentworth Street, new construction. Has been gone up by Mr. Clark. The fee is $2,425.
And what was that number?
30 Wentworth Street.
No, the building permit.
Oh, I'm sorry, 2017-070.
Are you getting 6 months?
Yeah, usually good for the year.
For new construction.
Yeah, and then they can come back for an extension for 6 months if they need to, is what we had before. The next one is 2017-072. It is 496 Locust Street. It is, they're remodeling. There's plumbing work and HVAC work. Mr. Clark has reviewed. It's a $225 fee.
I'll be right there, Jordan, I'll just sign it.
Okay.
Just realized I left this on.
And the next one is 2017-092, 235 Clement Road. What are we doing? Some roof work. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. We're not replacing the whole thing, just a section of it. It's a $75 fee. Until the end of the year, because I'm assuming we're getting the roof fixed before
where
next year.
Where are you staying, Michael?
It is 507 Portland Avenue. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. It's they're replacing the entryway, the front entryway, or small entryway, not replacing with a solid structure, just roof, floor, and roll-up vinyl sides, like a greenhouse, okay? Their words, not mine. I'm just trying to pick. Oh, okay. Now it makes more sense. Like a seasonal porch, I guess, on the back. So, anyway, Mr. Clark has reviewed it. So. Did I mark the gray part on that one? So. They're in the middle of doing this. So.
What's the fee on that?
Oh, sorry, it's $45. Next we have 2017-094, 10 Nordic Lane. They are working on their electrical system for their pool. The fee is $35 and it's also been reviewed by Mr. Clark. Isn't electrical standard $90?
No pool. No pool at 9 Nordic Lane.
Electrical, I believe it should be $90. Not 35. I'm going to make that a 90. Standard for electrical, unless it's greater. Next is 2017-095, 108 Woods Run. They are doing pool wiring. Again, it is a $90 fee. It should
should be.
Is there something special about the retirement?
I don't know, I don't think so, it's just electric, all electrical work is $90, includes administrative fee or project value, whichever is larger, so that should also be $90.
It used to be, but maybe he's just having a little brain.
It's probably a small service.
Well, he, if he thinks we're wrong, he'll come back and tell us. Entire project?
Yeah.
Alright, so, in the past, we've just done the standard, any electrical, so.
Yeah.
That's been the.
Oh, I agree.
Twenty-seven.
I don't know why he, I don't know why, he's not here, so.
I do not know why. 2017-096, 426 Washington Street. They are.
It's your neighborhood, isn't it?
It is not just your neighborhood.
I see.
I think that.
Really close.
She's intimately aware of, knowledgeable. Removing existing shingles and installing new on main roof, replace all and any damaged rod sheathing underneath. Mr. Clark has it as $165 fee. That one and that appears to be the end of that. We have a correspondence for some reason in this envelope. Let's see.
It's all confused. I don't know, you're opening up.
I think we'll be all right.
Maybe we want water here.
Me, I don't like that. I have a very good check now.
You're open.
This is from Blaze and Lori Beeks with 90 Wood Run, Rollinsford, to the assessors, Town of Rollinsford. Please let the photo service our notice to appeal the property tax assessment for the following reasons. That's enough. We do this, right? Hopefully we sent it to the.
We can ask Caroline to copy and forward.
We have provided details on why we believe our home is overassessed. Our home has 1¾ baths, not 2½ baths as listed. Our house is being taxed with water access. We feel it's inaccurate. There's no dock, there's no boat launch. There's just nor a clear path to the water. As our homeowner's insurance is not recognized as having any need for flood insurance due to proximity to water, we feel our tax bill should reflect this as well. The average proposed assessed value increases 49% for the woodlands compared to 18% for the rest of the similar neighborhood. Those valued over 400,000 in Rollinsford, we believe our assessed value should be in line with the rest of Rollinsford, and the classification of water access should be removed. We may be contacted, and I don't need to give out their phone number. We look forward to hearing from you in regard to this matter. And I will put it back on.
Yeah, do you have to post it so we can just ask Caroline to scan and send her back to talk?
Yeah, I'll take that one look at it and then put it all back together.
No, I think it's just similar to what we were. We'll have Jody put the post-it in.
And then the rest is, like I said, the veterans. So.
Okay, so we'll do that in non-public.
We'll discuss.
Yeah, okay. So you're done then, Michael?
I am.
Okay. Yes, yeah, we don't, yeah, okay.
So, nothing. The junkyard, it's still in here?
Yep, we haven't heard anything. We passed it on to Tom.
Tom, okay. So I'll leave it in here.
Yep.
Everything else.
Maybe I'll ask him for an update.
This side.
On behalf of the board.
Last time he came in, he mentioned that he had not responded to the applicant. And that was responding back at the state. A number of issues.
Right, that's what he told Caroline. I don't think he came in and told us.
What did he email to us?
Maybe, yeah. But we asked him the last time, I don't know, it was the board, I can't remember under which configuration, we asked Tom to send a letter to them, so. So let's just make sure that he's done that, that it hasn't slipped off his radar.
This was the new highway needs letter that we got last week, still in here, about 2 weeks ago. Auburn zoning ordinance, and it's pointed to.
Yes, I can speak to that.
I would love you to.
So when I met with Caroline this morning, she has come across this, I think it through her, one of her listservs. The town of Auburn has, in their zoning ordinance, a growth management section. You know, that limits the number of building permits per year for new construction.
Like Elliott does.
Like a certain, yeah, I'm sure there are many towns, we don't. So it just tries to get a measured, sort of a measured growth.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't believe that that's our business. I believe it's planning board business. So I think we should, if the board so chooses, we can ask Mike to bring this to the planning board with our encouragement to examine and.
I think that somebody on the planning board has mentioned that.
To us?
No, to at one of their meetings.
Okay, I don't go to that one. So shall we do that? So Mike, could you please? Yes. Because, you know, we have large tracts of land in town, and all you have to do is look at the pressures on Dover and the development going on in Dover. So, you know, it may be something that the planning board thinks it would be in the best interest of the town, and I think the board would like to encourage them to give it a serious thought.
Pass the meeting.
All right, excellent. Okay.
All right. Credit card charges on the card. I'm assuming this was in here for an FYI.
Yeah. Yes. So Mike, would you like to see them?
Okay. This is a bill from Urban Tree Service.
Yes, for me to speak to.
Invoice date was the 17th. Service date was August 15th. Emergency work, remove hazardous cherry trees at 624 Silver Street.
Yeah, so Jeff was not here, and the police saw the tree and had to have it removed. So they called Urban Tree.
Did it fall?
It fell. It was right across the road during one of these weather events. I think that the rainstorm we just had, I think.
Okay, because that's $800.
Yes, exactly.
Yes.
So, understood. So we have the $10,000 purchase order.
Which is on hold.
Which is on hold. So it would, because this is an emergency, whatever, it's not going to fall into that purchase order.
Right.
But I authorize payment because for emergencies, you've got to do it, so that's it. So if we do want to continue with that purchase order, we'll certainly have to take this payment into consideration.
I just put a little note for when we do.
Yeah, wonderful. So we don't forget, okay. So that's why it's there, so we could have this conversation and
mm-hmm.
talk about that.
That was the emergency service. Salt. There are
yes.
two things here for salt.
Yep. So I have some information. So I had asked, you may have seen, I copied you on this email to Jeff. I said, Jeff, how will salt proposals come to us? Do we have to ask people?
Right.
He says, no, you'll get them. And sure enough, we've gotten them. We'll get the salt proposals. We'll, and then you just figure out which one you want to sign, determine the amounts, and the like. And so I think they're both the same this year?
One is delivery. Morton Salt is $53.30 per ton. But this Granite State Minerals, based on the Newark, New Hampshire DOT, is pleased to extend the delivered price of $53.30 per ton of bulk road salt. Now, I know that there's a difference in salt and where you get it from and the kind of salt that each place has. So, if you would approve me, I would like to ask the person that I know salt very well.
Perfect.
What is
so, I'll just say, so we all remember, Jeff has liked Morton.
Right.
Because it doesn't clump the way that one does.
Right, great statement.
Yeah. So please get some research. I think that's a great idea. I'm going to remind the board what we've paid most recently, just as it appears to have gone down. So this current year, we are paying $58.27 per ton.
Okay.
So, yeah, so the price has come down. The other thing to keep in mind is the amount that we've put in, and Jeff's recommendation to Caroline, which he's passing along to board, is that we keep it the same. It's different from the budget amount. This is where I had a meltdown last year.
I recall.
Yes. So, because if you multiply it by the $53, it comes out to like $50,000. But it just is, it's a big number, so that we at least are guaranteed to get that salt, whatever salt we need, up to that amount at the price.
Right, because what happened 2 years ago is that the number was too low, they ran out of salt, and we weren't at the top of the list.
Right, that's correct. So that was the recommendation from, and I the number might be there, I don't know.
Yeah, 1,000.
Okay.
1,000 tons for within a year period.
And I did the math, and I got a meltdown.
Okay. There is a
bulk, I've learned.
There is a bulk blizzard wizard description valid from July 1st to June 30th, 2018, delivered, which is $70 per ton.
I mean, is that more?
So, well,
I mean, 70 instead of 53 would be 70
if
during a blizzard.
Right. No, I think it's a different type of salt. So.
Oh.
But once again, I'm gonna double check.
Yeah, please do.
Sorry.
Please do. It's a good idea. Mm-hmm. Is there a date by which they are wanting us to respond?
Short order is supposed to be placed by the first signatures.
September.
Mm-hmm. 3 days. Oh, August 2nd.
Alright, so do you think you'd be able to report to the board next Monday?
Oh, yeah.
And
do
you think the board would be ready to make a decision?
I can send you an email.
Okay, alright, so perfect. All right, so we'll manage it next Monday then.
Great.
Okay, sounds good.
Send it in your conversation. Do you want to move non-public for that, or is that public?
No, no, this is public.
Yeah, okay.
So one of the things that we needed from Caroline is the termination pay for Jeff. And so she worked it out, and I noticed it. I took a look at it today, and it had comp time, and we don't pay for comp time. So this is the, so it was a $5,000, almost $5,100 figure with the comp time. Without the comp time, it's $4,200.
Right, because we, the letter attached there says, like, we're granting you the comp time because...
It's to be used, yeah. It's not to be paid if he doesn't use it. It's for him to use it. He chose not to use it, but he's done. Well, that might not have been, you know, he had to ask us for 2 weeks in a row. The comp time, generally speaking, you use it is near to when you've earned it. Because,
mm-hmm.
You know, it's not something to carry in the books, not something to, you know, to provide an extended vacation necessarily. It's, you know. So it looks like the payout is $4,177.89. And Caroline said...
I'm not following. I'm sorry. Do we need a motion?
Well, yeah, I mean, we owe it to her, so...
Yes, second.
So second. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So, like, the schedule is, I think there's a, there's going to be a payroll, so his next paycheck is a full 2 weeks. One following will have just the 2 days, Labor Day and the day after. So in that pay period, she'll include this.
In the 2 day?
In the 2 day pay period. It will come out of his salary line.
Right.
Okay?
The IRS has informed us that they received our tax exempt bond form.
Yay.
Yay, IRS. University of New Hampshire Road Business Summer Doubleheader. So, talking about dams and culverts and roads and
same road scholar courses.
I think so. Yeah. So, save it for our next
road agent, absolutely.
Yep.
You know, one of the things that I would encourage the search committee as they interview people, you know, is their willingness, sort of motivation to take courses that seem relevant to the business of managing roads.
Okay. While we're on the topic, is there anything specific you two would like other than that?
Well, as we get closer, I think it would be good for us to have a conversation so we could be thinking about that. That's an excellent question. I would say just right now, you know, the willingness to, you know, to sort of grow in the position and to look for the latest changes in the field.
Yeah. AAA fence quote for a 6 foot high, one inch of barbed wire, gate at the transfer station. This was the email that was sent earlier in the week for Jeff had wanted a gate in the front, so it wasn't part of the improvements. But according to the email, said to hold off until the final bill came in or something like that.
Yeah, so we can consider it. If there's money in the warrant, I'm going to be surprised if there's money left in the warrant. So I made note of that in the budget prep for next year.
Okay.
But yeah, we'll see. You know, if we're waiting for one final bill from
Tom. Okay. And everything else is old from last week. So bridge aid, garden club, trees, copier, nothing. And then we'll have to go into non-public for
Yes, but before that, can we talk a little bit about what we heard tonight from Woods Run and how we want to proceed? And Denise left a comment. I think she said it to all of us. Were you all here?
I did.
And she felt that everyone's land went up disproportionately in this thing. So just to keep that in mind, if there's some kind of an adjustment on land, perhaps it's town-wide.
Mm-hmm.
So, are there, did the conversation tonight suggest something that the board would like to do?
Yeah. I think it would be good for us to sit down and meet with Chad and anyone else on Avatar that needs to come along. They need to explain to us the process they use this time. We need to have a conversation about the meetings they just had with these folks. They've all said to the person, every single one of them all said that Avatar admitted that their formula was flawed and that the town may need to be reevaluated. Almost every single person said that. Now, I can't imagine they all made up the same story, so.
I don't think I heard that they all said that Avatar said the town needed to be revalued.
They had said that they were wrong.
They were wrong.
Several times.
Yeah.
To several different
with persons. Regard to their own particular.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They're assessing.
Yes.
Right.
So if Avatar is admitting that they were wrong,
Well, let's, you know, let's hear what, so, is the best approach or a next approach to have Avatar come in and directly at one of our meetings?
Yes.
So the next Monday? If we get the thing out?
Did we just schedule something?
Did we? Can we schedule?
What's the 28th? We scheduled,
Welfare or conference.
Welfare guideline work session, well, if you can.
This is part of our meetings.
Six, so he could come in 6:30 or 7 or whatever.
Well, I'd like, just for whatever reason, I like to have 7 for people who are coming in.
I know he has young kids, I don't know, but it's easier for him to come in, what?
I'm sure he's, he can tell me.
Yeah.
So, shall we ask him to come in next Monday? If not, if somehow he can't, then we're into the, we're not available. Yeah, so the 6th, we need to do it sooner rather than later because of the timing of all of these things. So let's try to get him in Monday.
And if we can, then.
We'll punt and maybe see if we can arrange something for later that week.
Yeah,
No, just for that.
Yeah, I can do it every day but Thursday next week.
It's the only night that I'm available tonight.
So we would try for Wednesday?
I would try it, but if you only.
We would try for the 30th, is that?
Critical mass can do the 29th or the 31st, and that's what we can do, then do it.
All right, we'll shoot we're going to shoot for next Monday. We'll try 8:30, August 30, if 6:30 if it doesn't.
It needs to happen. This meeting needs to happen. He needs to come and have a conversation with us. And we need to take a look at what our contract with them says. I don't remember about discrepancies or if.
Would you like to read the contract? Do you want Caroline to send it?
If she can forward it to me again, I'd like to look at it. Yeah. What happens if we do have to have another townwide reevaluation? Right? Are we stuck with the cost of that, or are they responsible for doing it? And that our contract always tells us. So. And I don't remember. I don't look at it. If I don't remember.
Okay. So we'll work on that.
And I, you know, he should be prepared to explain to us how. That entire neighborhood, what the justification is for listing that as waterfront or water access. There may be a very well reasoned answer, and I don't know.
I mean, we need to come with an open mind,
right?
And not necessarily assuming that they.
Yeah, no, I honestly don't know why they would be, or why they should or shouldn't be.
Exactly.
I know that they have water access because there's a road and a sign, I think.
Yes.
I saw, and I was down there looking.
Yeah.
But I don't know what it means either. If it's just for, is it just water access for that neighborhood association? I mean, I don't know. Is it a public boat launch for the entire town? I have no idea. So that would be good to know.
So he did, so, and you all did get this message from him, so I.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, that he is reviewing it, but I think it's good for us to make sure that. Okay. All right, so I guess we wanted to come back and talk about that. So now I think, is it just the, so two issues of non-public. We have some credits exemptions, and then we have a personnel of, yes, that's the issue that I wanted to talk to you about with regard to the culprits.
Oh, okay. So can we also do a personnel on the highway too? Because there's some questions I wanted to ask, because I wasn't at the meeting when you all were in non-public.
Okay, so we'll just say personnel.
Personnel issues.
Okay. So I will entertain a motion to go into non-public.
Okay, so what we need to
do
the input first.
I think we need to do community first.
Yes.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Community.
Go ahead, you can go first.
Like it was reiterated this earlier this evening, we met with Avatar, my husband did, and got the same response that our land value has gone up across town, and that they adjusted our home value down, so our our assessment did not go up astronomically, but it still went up 18 to 20%.
Would you mind answering a question? How large of a lot do you have?
0.1. Is it 0.01 of an acre?
So a tenth of an acre?
A tenth of an acre.
Tiny, it's a postage stamp lot, basically. I mean,
yeah.
Right now.
And we bought it for roughly $235,000 in 2007. The next year it was assessed down to $160,000, and we've stayed there for the last 10 years. This year,
We bought the height of the buckle, you and I will. So
now it's assessed at $195,000 or $197,000, so it jumped $30,000. And Avatar told my husband, basically, the lots in town have gone up drastically because of some of the choices of the town, the school district, and so forth.
Could you answer
your
question? I had the same concern because we went in and asked the same thing because we have 0.4 acres and we're assessed at $96,000 for our land.
So she's valued more for her land when I have a half an acre and I'm valued at 88.
Mm. And they told me that it was the topography. Because my land is level and it doesn't have any slope in it, I get charged more for my land than someone that might have a little bit of a slope to their land.
Oh, so my steep hill saves me money.
Yeah, probably does. Seriously.
And
I mean, you know, there are the, you know, they've got, they kind of follow. How come I don't get a view tax? There's a method. Hard to get away from you of Oak Street get a view tax.
And my lot is 160 some odd thousand is how much they've valued my land at, just my lot.
The tenth of an acre, 160.
0.1. Is it 160,000?
Well, you're in a desirable area.
Exactly. So it's based on my neighborhood.
And it also has to do with our country residential.
Okay, so all right.
So there's lots that fall into it.
Thank you. Everybody's land went up.
Yes.
I think what he said is theirs went up in greater proportion to the rest of the town. That's their concern.
Okay, my other thing is can you tell me again who's on the search committee for the highway?
Yes, so right now we have
Michael
LaPointe, Nate Mears, Jason LaVoy, Nancy Dion,
okay,
and Jody LaVoy, Carnes.
Sorry.
You didn't mention
me. No, you didn't mention me.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I was wondering if I was
thinking about the DPW people.
But didn't you say Mike LaPointe wasn't able to?
He couldn't meet like at the end of August.
Oh,
he's
gonna be away. Oh, so it wasn't like a, he wasn't.
No, no,
he
was just.
All
right.
I see. Okay, I misunderstood.
Okay.
Probably wasn't clear. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to exclude you, Nancy.
No. So, in other words, Jody will be deciding the first meeting. Is that how
it will come
run?
From the board? Yeah. So likely Jody.
Okay.
We'll need to get our charge. You know, we're gonna review the charge next week and
all right. That
sort of thing.
I noticed nobody else on the budget committee.
Well, let me just say something. The board has every right to appoint the members of the search committee. Jody suggested we find a budget committee member. Mm-hmm. It was not up to the budget committee to decide who they were going to bring to our committee. So to us to appoint who we would like to do. So
Correct. We
did ask you, because
mm-hmm.
you come to all of the meetings, you're here, so we thought it was a good, you know, we asked for one of you.
I'm
and,
glad
you know,
that you put
somebody
it.
Somebody said, why don't you check in with the budget committee? So I did that. But I believe that, you know, that was by.
That was me saying check in so that all the ducks were in a
well,
row
they
so
could,
that
but
they couldn't.
You know, we can
yeah,
appoint whoever we want is really the bottom line. Oh, I got chastised.
Yeah.
Sorry.
By only one person.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
Okay.
So
that was it.
Thank you. Anything else? All right, then I will entertain a motion to go to non-public for those two purposes.
I'm going to move that we go into first to go into non-public session to do elevated benefits and veterans attention, then after that to go into non-public for personal issues.
Second. All right, I'll do a roll call on that. Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne? Yes.